Hi students, welcome back. Coming to the next topic in the subject, mobile computing was IEEE 802.11 architecture. So which is a Wi-Fi technology? It's nothing but it's a Wi-Fi technology. 802.11 means. So actually this IEEE 802.11, it defines two types of services will be provided. So first let me explain you what are the components that are present and how the operation will be performed in IEEE 802.11, that is a Wi-Fi technology. Actually, there are two types of services it is going to be provided. So what are the two types of services that it defines? One is the BSS service and another is ESS service. So BSS means basic service set. Basic service set. Then what about the ESS? ESS means extended service set. So by seeing these words, what you understand, it's a basic services is provided by this unit and extended services is providing by ESS unit. So now let's see what are the components that this architecture consists of. Later we will see the diagram. So the components that are going to present in this architecture was, first is a station. So we represent it as STA. So stations are nothing but the mobile nodes. My phone is one mobile node. Your laptop is another mobile node. Another gadget is another mobile node. So the node is nothing but some electronic device which are used to communication. And another component that we use is an access point. Access point, representing it as a AP. So this access point is nothing but the stations are connected to access points, means all the stations are connecting to one access point. Stations are connected to access point. Okay. And the basic services set, that is BSS, the basic service set is, it's nothing but, what's the use of basic service set? Stations and the access point, stations and access point with the same radio coverage form, with the same radio coverage form. Forms a basic service set. So the basic service set is consisting of a stations as well as the access points. All are present within the range. So this complete set you call it as a basic service set. Then what about the extended service set? The extended service set is a several basic service set. Means suppose this, there are several BSS are there. So all those BSS, you call it as extended service set. Several BSS, basic service sets, connected through access points form an extended service set. Okay. So this IEEE, whenever you asked about what is an IEEE 802.11 architecture, means it's just a Wi-Fi technology. So you need to explain the architecture, how the communication is establishing in Wi-Fi technology. There are two types of services that are defined by IEEE. One is this BSS, basic service set, and extended service set. And these are the components that are present in this service set. Okay. And the portal will be there here. And some more components that are the portal. A portal is nothing but is the bridge to other wireless. So wide network, whatever the wide network that is present. So for that, the portal is acts as a bridge to other wired network. And distributed system will be there. Distribution system. So the distributed system is nothing but the interconnection network to form a logical network. It's just an interconnection network which is used to form a logical network, that is an extended service set based on several BSS. So these are all the different components that are present in the architecture. So now let me show you how the architecture will be look like. So let us take, this is one access point and another access point. So let us take one portal. The portal is acting as a bridge to other wired network. So let us take, this is a wired network, which is a LAN. So these are all the wireless networks. So wireless network. So this access point consisting of one BSS and another BSS. So each BSS consisting of some devices, the mobile nodes. So communicated by the access point. Okay, so let's take, this is a station STA1, station 1, station 2. There's a mobile nodes, station 3. It's stations are nothing but the mobile nodes. And this is the distribution system. And this is a portal which is acts as a bridge to other wired network. So this wired network is 802 dot something LAN, local area network. And one or more BSS are connected, then that you call it as a extended service set. So this is how the communication will be established in the this architecture of the wireless local area network. So here the wired will be there, wireless will be there. So the infrastructure, the two types of wireless networks I said. So one is the infrastructure and another is the ad hoc. So here we are using the infrastructure as an access AP, as an access point. So with the help of the access points, the devices are communicated through wireless. So which is a basic service set you call it as. And one or more basic services are connected, then you call it as an extended service set. Okay, so let me show you the IEEE standard of 802.11 more clearly. IEEE standard 802.11 technology. So let us take the mobile terminal here. This is a mobile terminal. Okay. And some access point will be present somewhere. Access point. So this access point is connected to some infrastructure. Okay. So this is the infrastructure network. So from this infrastructure network, a wired communication will be there. So let us take the laptop, which is a fixed terminal, or a desktop computer, which is a fixed terminal. So this is a mobile, which is a wireless, and here some access point will be there. This mobile will reaching the signal through this access point. So this access point is connected to the wired infrastructure network. So it is distributing to other devices, whether it may be a mobile networks or it is a fixed terminals, whatever it may be. So how the, let's see here the standards for each. Let's take the mobile device here. The mobile wants to send the information to this fixed terminal. So here the, it's consisting of the application layer, TCP layer, next IP layer, LLC, logical local circuit, and 802.11 MAC address, which is a data link layer, and 802.11, which is a physical layer. Okay, so .2.11, which is a Wi-Fi technology. Okay, so here this access point consisting of only LLC. And it is having 802.11, which is a wireless MAC, and 802.11, which is a physical wireless, and 802.3 MAC. 802.3 means it's a wired communication. 802.3, it's a physical wired communication. So from here, the data will goes here, and from this, this is completely, this part is a wireless communication and this part is a wired communication. So the wired communication, again it's connected to this fixed terminal. The fixed terminal again consisting of the application, TCP, IP, LLC, and this is 802.3 MAC address, so which is a wired, and 802.3 and physical, which is a wired communication. So this is how the operation will be performed in IEEE standard 802.11. So this is a wireless and this is a wired communication. How the data will be transferred from this terminal to this terminal, how the internal operations, that, I mean how the internal different layers that will be present, how the communication will be established. So from application to like this, it is going. Application, TCP, IP, LN, and 802.11 MAC address and the physical address is converting into this, sends to the access point device. So this access point, we have the infrastructure and the wireless, both will be there. So this is an infrastructure and this is the wireless. So which is ad hoc, you call it as ad hoc. Okay. So this is a wireless and this is a wired communication. So this is about the architecture of the IEEE 802.11. Thank you.